Major General Jones is passing the colors to Colonel Nyland, the incoming commander, charging him with the responsibility for the unit as its new garrison commander.
Fort Meade Garrison Commander Chris Nyland receiving the garrison colors from Major General Omar Jones, Commander Military District of Washington, in ceremonies August 18th at Club Meade. We'll have more with the new commander in just a moment. Also this week, the Army Wellness Center is reopening. ASAP offers a drug alert, and we'll check in with the safety office. These stories and more, but first, it's been a matter of days since Colonel Chris Nyland took command of the garrison. He introduced himself at this week's COVID-19 Town Hall.
I'm a military brat. I grew up all over the world, generally outside of military posts. But I do claim Seattle's home. Actually, Colonel Michael and I went to college together at the University of Washington. I am married. My wife is also an Army colonel. She commands an MI brigade here on post. From a military career perspective, I'm an infantryman. So the garrison is a new experience for me. My most recent assignment was working in the Office of the Secretary of Defense on his staff, working for the Assistant Secretary of Defense of Manpower and Reserve Affairs. And I'd say the great part about that job was that it allowed me to see a lot of the challenges that the garrisons are dealing with from a very strategic level. The biggest challenge I have up front is earning your trust. And I think the way that I do that is by being transparent, communicating with you regularly, and honestly, doing what I tell you I'm going to do.
We'll have an extended conversation with Colonel Nyland on an upcoming episode of our podcast, Fort Meade Declassified. Stay tuned. Meanwhile, Army Wellness Centers offer a variety of preventive health programs to virtually all DoD ID card holders. Fort Meade Center closed since March. It's reopening August 31st.
I've been working with the infection prevention coordinator pretty closely to make sure that the building is ready and that we're following all of the CDC guidelines and making sure that we're meeting the commander's intention for safety. So we're only coming back with restricted services, those that are lower risk of transmission, and making sure that we can ensure people feel safe when they're coming to see us.
Navarro adds that even after reopening, programs offered will be a mix of on-site and virtual.
So we will have the BOD pod. We're also doing metabolic testing. And then we'll have our stress management sessions as well. And we can do one-on-one health coaching. And the health coaching we've been doing over the phone and doing virtual coaching. We'll offer it in person as well now, but we will still have the virtual option.
The Wellness Center is located at 2474 Ernie Pyle Street, adjacent to Kimbrough. In a related story, the Army Substance Abuse Program is continuing its virtual drug alert series this week. It features former Baltimore County drug czar Mike Gimble, who was a guest on a live town hall we hosted on our Facebook page earlier this summer.
We're going to introduce one a week, starting in September, the first Tuesday in September. And we're going to do this on Teams, but you'll also be able to watch it on YouTube if you don't have access to Teams as well. And it'll be 1300 to 1400. And we would do some interacting with teams and the units and the government workers. And on the rest of the community, you still can watch it on YouTube and kind of see what I'm talking about.
You need to register by email in order to receive the links to the webinars and to receive the annual training credit for substance abuse. In other news, every year at this time, we check in with the Installation Safety Office about back-to-school safety. Obviously, with a virtual start to the year, things are a little different.
So the first thing you got to remember is supervision. So some people are working at home, so we got to be aware that those kids need to be supervised. We got to have that balance between work and supervision. Secondarily, since people are home more, then those secondary risks that we're not worried about as much now become primary. So all those things about the house, the tripping hazards, the electrical outlets, all those kind of things, that's a good time. You know, I can only talk so long, but I want you to review all those safety things at home.
A final reminder, the Armed Services Blood Program is holding a blood drive Tuesday, September 8th from 9 to 1 at the McGill Training Center. You can make an appointment at www.militarydonor.com and use the sponsor code FTMEAD. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.